Imagine doing something no one's ever done before. Walking into the complete unknown. Because that's what it was. We were doing something we loved to do. We were selling dental equipment. Going into dental offices, meeting girls, selling dental, baby.
We were just kids. We didn't know what we were doing. We had no idea that it would lead to anything.
You gotta understand what was happening in the world at that time. Reagan in the White House, MTV, the war in Iraq. We were like, shut up, man, we just wanna sell dental.
Our competitors call us loud, crazy. Like, what's the problem with them?
I must have gotten the other guys kicked out of at least 40 or 50 accounts in just one summer. And those were their family and friends.
We weren't doing what the reps in Chicago were doing. We weren't doing what the reps in New York City were doing. We were doing our own thing.
All of a sudden, these guys from Benco came down. And this was real. This was big.
The Carolinas was so intriguing.
And we were part of a thing that was really big with Benco.
It was like, this thing can evolve. This thing's growing. And we're growing with it.
Everything changed in the napkin. This guy brought so much style. He was polished.
I was like, Dwayne Nettle, isn't this guy Tom Hopkins' protege or something? Wasn't he on the high school golf team?
And Nettle, he just came in with a total disregard for what had been done before him.
I was just a kid, and I was the biggest thing in the neighborhood. Bigger than Pearl Jam, and it was the best time of my life. Bigger than Michael Jordan.
It was a great time. But it was a great time all the time. You know, sometimes that's just too much.
Things were getting out of control.
This wasn't like it was last year.
Nettle, the star that burns that bright has to burn out sometime.
I miss the guy I used to know.
I have a few friends that are in jail, a few friends that hate my guts. And I'm thinking to myself, this isn't the way it should be.
Where's the fun? This isn't fun anymore.
You know what, that's it. This interview is over. It's over.
We outstripped our own personal resources. When you do that, you try to find a way out. Sometimes, bad, illegal ways.
I went my way, and the rest of the game, they went there.
What we used to love as kids had become a curse. I knew there was only one way to save the Carolina crew.
Steve and I had to trick everyone to let them know that Chuck and Rick are coming to give us foot massages because we're so super fantastic. I knew that would get their egos back here.
It was like an intervention. Ted was there, Ellen Landis, Sharon Shivitz.
It was a mess.
The Benco guys came in and they showed us all these exciting new tools. They got the earnings accelerator scorecard. You get your big deals, you get your quarterly promotions.
It was like walking blindly in the desert, and all of a sudden the cones came down from the mountaintop, and it was like a paradigm shift. It was unfreaking believable.
Dwayne thought it was all bullshit.
It was tough times, but Brad Bingaman told me, ear game. Put it up.
Throw it on the ground.
Stomp it. Nobody can steal my joy.
Be at the house, and some guy's wife will come up to you and say, aren't you guys selling stuff today? You know, it's like, yeah, right, selling stuff.
People say I'm no good, crazy as a loon, 'cause I get stoned in the morning, and I get drunk in the like my old blue tick hound. I like to lay around in the shade, and I ain't got no money, but I damn sure got it made. 'Cause I ain't asking nobody for nothing if I can't get it on